To me, the thing that made Green Lantern different than all the rest is the element of fantasy and that other worlds exist besides our own and that you get to go to those other worlds in this movie. And the fact that there's the planet Oa, the home base to the Green Lantern Corps in the center of the universe, and how you could introduce alien species and go to another world, so you got to go between Earth and another world, is what made it a real extraordinary possibility to take advantage of the technology that exists now between CGI and the 3D technology, obviously, and to really deliver something that people hadn't seen in a superhero movie in that regard. I think what makes Hal Jordan compelling as a character is, first of all, he is the first human being to be chosen to be a Green Lantern. So it's a very human story, and it's about why human beings are unique and why human beings are special. There's 3,600 Green Lanterns. All of them are from other galaxies and other races besides Earth and human beings. So they have a lot of curiosity about Hal Jordan. What is this guy made of? Human beings seem to them a young species, not the most advanced species. You know, we're kind of, you know, a little bit ignorant as to what is in the rest of the universe compared to a lot of other races and planets that exist. So there's a bit of a kind of joke made about that. And there's a bit of cynicism about, can a human being really rise to this occasion and be a true hero the way a lot of these other more evolved species can be? So it's very relatable and very interesting for all of us, obviously, as human beings, we speak about the human condition and about, you know, what makes humans special. In the mythology of the Green Lantern, the ring selects its next bearer. So in our story, we see a Green Lantern meet an untimely end at the beginning of the movie, and the ring selects the next bearer. So the ring knows instinctively. It's not going to choose someone who doesn't have it within him or her to be everything a Green Lantern needs to be. That person or that being may not know, but they're going to go on a journey of discovery. So the ring knows that deep inside there are those qualities. And that's what is so surprising to Hal Jordan, because he really, quite frankly, does not. He thinks the ring has made a mistake. And he walks away from this responsibility because he's frightened of it. He doesn't think he's worthy of it. So we get to watch what happens and how he's confronted with these obstacles along the way and how he really finds out what he's made of by the end of the movie. And I think that's a really satisfying, just basic emotional story. If you love movies, this is the ultimate, you know, movie fans kind of movie. It's, you know, you go in that theater and we take you to a whole new world, literally. So you're not only going to have 3D and incredible visuals to look at, but we're going to take you from the planet Earth and our everyday lives into the center of the universe to a new planet. So you're going to get to go on that incredible ride, just on a pure entertainment level. It's going to be spectacular, great action, and a great human story. So a character that anchors you, Hal Jordan, you know, who we can relate to. We all will relate to his problems and his dilemmas, and we're going to kind of go on this classic hero's journey with him. So it's got all the great classic storytelling elements to it, and it's exciting. You know, it's just, it's a great ride.